Hi, it's Elizabeth. Today, I'm going to show you three ways to get Microsoft 365, formerly known as Microsoft Office, entirely for free, with no subscription required. It includes popular apps like Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. Best of all, it's completely free and it's entirely legal. The only thing required is an internet connection. Let's take a look. You'll want to get started by going to Microsoft365.com. And on here, you'll see a few options. The first is the sign-in button. If you have an existing Microsoft account, this could include Office products, Xbox, Skype, etc., you can go ahead and sign in here and you'll be prompted for your password. If you don't have an existing Microsoft account, I'll go ahead and show you how to sign up for one for free. You'll see next here to the sign-in button is Get Microsoft 365. This is the options for if you want to pay for a yearly or monthly subscription. But today, we're only focusing on the free. If you have not yet created a Microsoft account, go ahead and click Sign Up for the free version of Microsoft 365. Here, you'll be prompted to create your account. Go ahead and enter the email address that you want to be associated with your Microsoft 365 free account. Once you are logged in, you will see many familiar favorites, including Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, and a bunch of other Microsoft products. You can access your documents online from anywhere you have internet access, even when using a shared computer. Let's take a look at an example using Word. Since you do need an internet connection to use Microsoft 365 for free, you may find that you will be saving documents to your computer, uploading them when you have an internet connection, working on them, and then downloading them again to your computer. I am going to upload a document from my computer and show you how we can edit it in Word online and then save again to my computer. Once you have found your document, go ahead and click and open it. Your document should then begin to upload automatically. You may notice that sometimes the formatting does not transfer 100%, so you may have to do some brief adjustments when first uploading a document. But once you save it, it should transfer back and forth seamlessly. I've begun doing some market research on Kevin's Cookie Company. You can go ahead and make edits to your document online now. It has similar editing functionalities as you might be used to in the offline version of Word. Let's say I want to go ahead and insert a table. Any edits that I make to my document are automatically saved online. You can then go back and edit this document from any computer as long as you have internet access and log in to your Microsoft 365 account. You can also go up to the File button and download a copy to be saved onto your computer. Once you have the document saved to your computer, it functions just as any Word document should, meaning you can email it to somebody else, post it elsewhere online. The only thing you won't be able to do is edit it unless you have an internet connection and go on to your Microsoft 365 account. Once a document has been saved to your online account, you can access it at any time. Here on the home screen, you see that there's a quick access section, which has recently opened documents. You can come back and work on this at any time. Similar functionalities exist for Excel, PowerPoint, and any of the other Microsoft software programs. Another clever way to get Microsoft 365 for free, go ahead and on your keyboard, select Ctrl, Alt, Shift, and the Windows key button. You'll see that it looks almost identical to when we accessed it from Microsoft365.com. We can also see that under Quick Access is the market research plan that I worked on previously. Let's go ahead and take a look at creating a new document. Over here on the left-hand side, I'm going to click on PowerPoint. Here you can go ahead and start with a blank presentation or take a look at some of the templates. You'll see that some of the templates do have a diamond on the top right-hand side, which indicates that they are only available if you purchase a Microsoft 365 subscription. If you want to go ahead and create a blank presentation for PowerPoint, go ahead and double-click. It will open for you automatically, and again, you will be able to use most of the same functionalities in the free version as you would in the paid subscription version. Once you've made your edits, you'll go ahead and save this just as we did previously. You'll save a copy online, and you can also download a copy directly to your computer. A third option to getting Microsoft 365 for free is specific to educators and students. Students and educators at eligible institutions can sign up for Office 365 education for free, which includes Word, Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, and now Microsoft Teams, plus additional classroom tools. You could see if you are eligible by typing in your school email address. The link to this page is below in our video's description. That's three ways to get Microsoft 365 for free with no subscription. If this was helpful, please consider supporting our channel by subscribing below. See you next time.